Hello everyone, this is Henry Lee here at my home studio, Blue Heron Arts. If you have followed me recently on Facebook, you have seen some of the large painting, the banana leaves, I will say. Not exactly the petal, but you can treat it as petal because it's so colorful, the outer petal. I'll just show you the size of that. And the material we're going to use are gouache, acrylic gouache as black. It's a new experiment I learned from my dear friend Bill Buckman in Florida. He just diluted the acrylic gouache to get ink. I think that's pretty cool. And I'm going to use other non-traditional materials. So you can, I think I just use this spoon to dilute it to the consistency. I don't have to make it even always, you know, some light, some dark is okay, I think. Well, you can make it dark, then dilute it. So let's just put that aside. And I also have white. Let me put some here. So we need some pink to do the flowers. And I'm going to use Dr. Martin's TECH, I think it's maybe Tech Drawing Ink. I think it's acrylic. It could be Indian ink, I'm not sure. I think it's acrylic because it dries and it would not remelt. So when you wet mount it, there shouldn't be any problem. This pink, some rose. I think I better shake it. And some yellow. Some orange. I'll use everything a little bit. This of a little bit of that. Let's just do it. Okay. The reason I'm using ink is because the paper I got here is rice paper, triple shine, triple ply. Oh, I got ants. Anyway, so you can use acrylic with rice paper, but because the body of the acrylic is a little heavy, so I use heavier paper. And it takes a lot of moisture. If you use watercolor, it tends to pair off. But it will come back after mounting, maybe. It always turns much lighter than I expect. This color, by the way, is very vibrant. So I think it will balance it with the paper, so you don't have to mount it to see the effect. There's some pretty nice colors here. I think the only thing I miss is the green. Let's just do some here. We can mix yellow with blue, I think. Anyway. So let's start. You can see close up of this flowers has a very curly tip. It turns back, and on the end is like a big giant bamboo shoot. that's edible actually. I have bought one from the supermarket while waiting my bananas to mature. You can cut it, that you know, the remaining flower when it's you got, you know, when you got enough fruits, you cut the last part of the bud to eat. Actually, it's very delicious. It tastes like a tender bamboo shoot. Anyway, let's use a large brush for the flower. So I use a grape brush. You're supposed to hold it, you know, like this, I think. You can also hold traditionally because the handle is thin. In this case, okay. So wet the brush first, then I will load lighter. I'm not even gonna touch the gouache. I just use some yellow for the light on the bottom of my brush, and then some rose without blending it. Just have a go. So I add some darker color. Break the wet. Okay. And then the outer petals. Should go back. Anyway, it's kind of huge because the brush is large. You can cover the mistakes later if you don't like it with the leaves. So in the beginning, I just kind of go very bold. The banana flowers, banana is from the little flowers. I will add that with green later. So that's about it. Actually, I can do some banana on top of that. Supposedly, this is the last part of the flowers, and you can have a long stem with bananas. Okay, now I will use, maybe just use this brush. Use black. Black is the basic color for leaves in Chinese painting. Make a contrast. Should be dark. You can void that petal if you want, or just cover it. I think I just void it. Squeeze out the imaginative stem in the middle. So when I work on dark, I pay attention on the white, squeeze out the, yeah, so I don't have to paint the white. We save it, okay? I use a smaller brush now to do the stem of the flower. It's green. Use a little gouache to make it lighter. That's a nice color. Add a little warm color to it. It comes with knobs like bamboo, actually. Okay, now I add a little bananas. Need some more glue. Let's see if there's some yellow, blue, green, and some don't have to blend too well. They come in a cluster of 6 by 2, so 2 layers. You don't have to do them all, but it's good to know the number. And let's see, the older ones is more greenish. Now just use some purple kind of color to dot the end of the fruit, you know, the remaining dried flower. Each banana is from an individual flower blossom. It's a little dark to add some bones to the painting. You can use a little darker green. Depths to the floor, you know, the banana has these corners. And it's already have some there from the flying white, so you don't have to add too much. Just add a little darker tones there, or shady part, for the shady part. Add some yellow for the flower. You can also use some white. It's a very kind of like a light yellow white kind of. Not so colorful as the altar petals. These. Okay. If the color is not enough, you can use smaller brush just add a little bit color to it. Purple maybe. This is the petals like these. I'm doing life size. Okay. That's about it. Just curve this way. Give a little depth to it. This brush now is very dry. I didn't wet in water because I want to just touch the wet surface with a dry, very dry brush, pure ink. Keep the consistency very high, pure consistency. And you can use the white to dot these areas on the dark, suggesting more flowers. All right. Oh, we can do a hummingbird. I don't have room. Let's see what we can do. You can add the veins with even darker ink. Here we got the jet black in acrylic gouache. Use a little bit pure one, but maybe too thick if you don't dilute it. One thing I have to remind you that you have to wash the brush. And then don't use your best brush. You may ruin it if you forgot to wash it on time. Very dry to unwet, so it breaks the wet to create depth. You can add a little bit to the stem to with a little green pink maybe. Okay, don't overdo it. Do I have, I got some dirty hand. So I have to wash my hand. Just clean my hand. All right, that's an accident, but I will take advantage of that to do a bird. So that's the beak of the hummingbird, I think. Can you see that? Let me zoom in there. This is the stain I just got from my dirty finger. And I'm going to make it into a hummingbird. Let's use a little gray for the chest. You can use some gouache in it, make it soft. This is oval shape for the body, okay? And then you can do the tail. It's about the same size of the oval. Okay, now about half oval is the head. We can just use green plus a little ink. The non-neck, hummingbirds have a non-neck. use a little darker blue, maybe green. Okay, do the back. The wing is blurry, so you, if you don't use a very high-speed camera, you don't really see the wings. But we can do the wings on the painting with light, very pale gray. The Z, you know, the wing. They have this long feather, flying feather, very short wing. Bone, how to say this? So it's very blurry. Just use some water. You can do this side very suggestively. This gesture. A little bit tail there. Break it into the wet, blend into the wet. Okay, now I'm going to use a very small brush to do the details on the eye with the acrylic gouache, just a round eye there, and then some the trademark of the hummingbird is this red throat, but they're actually reflection. So you have to create a dark base first with the black. And then some, just use Chinese color, I think. I got some dried Maris Vermilion. You can use the same ink. Let me just use the, see if they mix. Okay. Just a little bit. Dark. And the feet is really hidden, so we just use a little dark to suggest that when they fly, you don't really see that. Just keep the proportion very small. They're so tiny. When I held it in the hand the other day, one of them just came to inside out of our home, so I rescued him, and it feels no weight, you know, very, it's like a penny, only like weighted like a penny. That's it. I'm going to sign. Let me see. Where should I sign? I think on this corner, maybe. Or this will be too tight. What is that? Signature is part of the composition, so we'll be very careful. Looks like I can sign with a small signature right there. Or a little more. You can put a seal on this side, I think. So let's make this part the dance part. So I just sign with my acrylic gouache, dilute it with water, otherwise I cannot write. Actually, I'm painting over the shoulder of you, and then my camera is in front of me. And just squeeze in here. Year of the dog. Henry Xiaohui, my Chinese name, given name. Okay, and here's my seal. Okay, that completes the painting. I can also add one more seal on the corner. I have a whole lot of seals at home. Okay, let me see. I have this seal says learn from nature. 诗造化. This seal is kind of like a corner seal, but not on the lower corner, but on the upper corner. A side seal, maybe. Just to block the qi from escaping the energy. So it will go like, you know, it's just the red spot. In the composition, you balance the composition. So this is a non-traditional painting with acrylic gouache and ink. Dr. Martin's drawing ink, tech drawing ink, and gouache, acrylic gouache. So it's very vibrant. You can wet mount it without the worry of smearing when it's dry, and you can dry mount it, of course. The best of this paper is like it's very heavy. You don't have to mount it if there's no wrinkle, you know. It's a triple shrine, triple weight, very heavy rice paper, the heaviest. You can get only on our website. Blue Heron Arts, we ship worldwide. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye. Happy painting. Don't miss anything in your garden in the spring.